in, you're gonna have to shout some stuff at our face. And we're not all used to doing that in everyday life. So on the count of three, just tell me your name. One, two, three.
Hey.
Very good. Now on the count of three, tell me who you came here with. One, two, three.
Hey.
Great. Now on the count of three, tell me who you wish you came here with. One, two, three. Cooper here. And some shows we've done in the past are Flies in My Tea, Bayou Bromance, and The Saddest Tree. So there's just some examples, but to get us started, we need a location for this musical to take place. Probably a location where a lot of people might get together. So on the count of three, shout a location at my face. One, two, three!
Nice job!
Alright, what did you say?
Reindeer Farm.
Reindeer Farm! All right, and now we need a title of a musical that happens at a reindeer farm. One, two, three!
Hold on,
what was that? What did you say?
Who spiked the eggnog?
Who spiked the eggnog? So ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first and last performance of Who Spiked the Eggnog? Invincible reindeer.
And invisible?
Sure, it can be invisible too. You make one invincible reindeer, and how long does it last?
Forever.
So you can't sell them another one when that one goes kaput in a very painful fashion.
Oh.
See what I'm saying? It's all about business. You gotta have business sense, Sal, or else you're never gonna be, you know, you're never gonna rise to my rank.
I'm sorry, Timbaugh.
It's all right.
I just feel bad filling them with berries and tacks.
Berries and tacks is the best food for any little reindeer.
It just makes them die so much quicker.
But look at this at the bottom. Organic.
Organic?
Organic berries and tacks. We wouldn't ever give any of our reindeers anything worse than organic. Sally, you gotta look at the bright side of things. Oh. You gotta look up even when things are looking down. You know what I'm saying, Sal?
I do, I think.
You think?
I think.
Well, let me sell it to you straight. Sure, things aren't always as you want them to be. Because life can be pretty sad, you see. But don't let that get you down. Let me take you for a ride. I'm gonna teach you how to look on the bright side. Take his food, for instance. Sure, we give all our reindeers berries and tacks.
Yes, organic tacks.
This food makes them die really painfully and really fast. But hey, take a look. You can grab all their skin and turn it into a high kick. Come with me and we'll look on the right side.
Merry fucking Christmas. Fa la 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 la.
Thank you so much for accompanying me out here. Didn't seem like you wanted to, but...
Yeah, I wouldn't miss it. I love watching you cut down a tree instead of going and buying it at the fucking store like everyone else.
Oh, well, you can't have just a store-bought tree.
Nope.
You gotta have a tree from the wild. You gotta go out there, you gotta find just the right tree. Just the one that speaks to you and just says, hey, Merry Christmas.
We found the tree. Cut it down.
Oh! It breaks my heart to know that this tree's gonna die.
You've already cut through it. Just keep going. It's dead.
Yes, I did this to do this once a year. You want some hot cocoa?
I want you to cut the tree down.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Marianne.
Here it goes.
Crash!
Bam!
Gentle as that on soft snow of the new year.
It was beautiful, majestic. I can't wait to see it.
Marianne, you're always such a curmudgeon around the holidays.
What's there to celebrate?
Well, your family business does so great. Everyone's happy. I made some hot cocoa.
Yeah, we have a family in the toy industry. Ho, ho, ho. This is the busiest time of year. You think I ever saw my father this time of year? You think Mr. Claus ever came down my chimney? No. He was down every other fucking chimney in the world.
Marianne. I'm gonna ask you something. I don't mean to be insulting.
What?
Hole in your stocking?
You dare ask
did you?
Me?
Well, no
you
one's.
You know who I
no one acts like
you,
this!
You know, I am a Claus. Do you think I got coal? I was a good little girl. But I'm not a little girl anymore.
It's a rock.
I found it. You went all the way outside for this?
No, it was under Mistress's shoe. I found it as she stepped in.
That makes sense. You're too much of a hypochondriac to go outside. This is everything.
I kissed it. It has love now. Someday
love.
You may have love.
Wow.
Next present!
Oh, yes, I got my own present this year. Just like every year. And the years before those two. Excuse me, can you move? Thank you.
Is it?
It's just a box, and inside there's just air for me to breathe.
The gift of life!
So I can finally feel free from these walls.
That's beautiful. Thank you for sharing, Icarus.
Next present.
Okay. Did you hear me? Isabella, I don't want you to feel like you have to repay me in any way for this.
All right. I'm excited. I'm excited. I can't open it. I'm excited!
Isabella! I can't open this. It's wrong. It breaks the rules of secret parent.
Okay. I'm just so excited right now. I just don't want this feeling to go away. Once I open it, I won't be excited anymore.
I hope for your sake it's air.
It's okay. This is the happiest day of our lives. We have to spend it as happy as we can for as many minutes as we can.
Okay. Thank you, Gemma. I'm going to open it.
I made it. I took the orphan master's coat and I stuffed it with napkins and I turned it into a body pillow so you could always have a hug.
I'm so happy!
I'm so happy too!
I'm so happy!
I am also happy.
Pillow.
I was thinking angel, but I don't want to be too, you know.
How's the air, Icarus?
The air? Why, it's almost like the nicest air I've ever tasted.
How's the brook, Gemma?
Well,
bye.
this year?
You don't stand a chance, Casper!
Oh yeah, you don't think so?
You're gonna be left in my snowy dust, Sandcasper!
Yeah, we'll see about that! But first, the traditional song of the reindeer king!
Hello!
Sally.
Hey. I was doing my normal job. Tax and berries.
You talked to them.
What?
You talked to the reindeer?
Yeah. Sometimes. Sometimes.
I do too.
You do?
Yeah. Sometimes I come out late at night and I just kind of tell the reindeer kind of just what I'm thinking.
Really?
Yeah.
I talk to the reindeer when I'm feeding them normally, and can I ask you something?
Sure.
When you talk to the reindeer, do you care about their feelings bodily and emotionally?
I care about the reindeer inside and out.
I've been feeding the reindeer leaves.
Oh, thank God. I've been coming in here and I've been feeding them cheesecake. And they love it.
You were touching my hand in the bucket.
Yeah. Sorry. Okay. Yeah, Chester loves cheesecake. He loves it. I make it myself.
Vaughn loves leaves.
Yes.
They seem happier than with the tacks.
Why did they give him tax? It's not.
So he'll die soon. Make him sell more. It's how businesses work.
It's just like the tech industry.
No, I think that raising reindeer, but I just want them to be happy and healthy.
Yeah, my mom, she actually got a reindeer from this farm.
Really?
But she had to take it back because, like, 6 months later, it was just so. It had so many bugs. But by then, the warranty had expired.
Understand, it would only last about a week.
I mean, it'd be one thing if, like, they helped you when you came here.
No. No. Tim Bob wants them to die very quickly, but just after the warranty expires. They just look so happy when they're fed well.
People used to have pride in the product.
Yeah. This may seem silly, but would you be interested, perhaps, in forming a coup? Would you?
Yeah, but we just need to make sure we have enough people on our side so that if when we take over. You know, if there's no one to run the farm, everyone walks out, and then nothing's worth anything.
We'll run the farm,
but we have to have, like, you know, people. We can't just run
the reindeers.
Okay.
You mean the reindeer?
A hostile takeover is sad.
So excited. A hostile takeover.
We can innovate on this product. Have something that's going to change the world.
Make the reindeers happy.
Reindeers all over the world, able to fly from point A to point B.
Without falling down and spewing blood. Beautiful dream. Beautiful, beautiful dream.
With a little hard work and some blood, sweat, and tears. How they use reindeers.
With a little thought and ingenuity, we will put the reindeer back how they used to be. A hostile takeover, me and you. A hostile takeover, me and you.
Thank you.
you are. Should have smelt the whiskey.
Don't tell me that's your father, Marianne.
God's sakes, Dad, you looked at yourself lately. You're not wearing any pants. Just the top part of your suit and a hat.
I like this.
You look ridiculous.
I look how I feel.
Ridiculous?
Yeah.
Don't cry. It's too late for tears, Dad. Where's Mom, Dad? Where's Mrs. Claus? No one's seen her.
Hey, she left of her own accord.
Oh, she left. Like the reindeer leave every season in a explosion of blood.
Because like more and more kids every year, for whatever reason, they stop believing in me. She stopped believing in me, too. That was mostly whiskey.
What's there to believe in? Look at yourself. You're a washed-up, moth-eaten, fat little donut of a man soaking whiskey, sprinkled with the leftover sprinkles of last year's birthday cake.
Ooh, I will give you such coal if you keep talking to me that way.
Give me coal. It'll keep me warm in the winter.
Marianne, come on. I know we've had a rough few years.
That's right, 25 years. I'm 26 years old.
Come on. Your mom's been gone for at least, like, 13 of them. On and off, she came back. But, like, it's hard being